Hi, PhotoPillers. We're here today to show you how to use PhotoPills to know where the moon will be during the next total eclipse, which will happen during the 27th and 28th of September, by the end of the month, depending on where you live, okay? For the eclipse, you will need to know the path of the moon during the eclipse in the sky, okay? And I'm going to show you how to use PhotoPills, the planner and the augmented reality, just to know where to frame if you want to capture the eclipse. Right, then, what you should do is just go to the planner, place the observer's pin, the red pin, right on the shooting spot, and I've already set the day to the 28th of September, because here in Spain we'll see the eclipse during the 28th. And all you have to do is set time at the beginning of the eclipse, which is 11 past 2 a.m. in the morning, right? Then this thin blue line, which is pointed south, is telling you that the moon will be in this direction, right? And in the top panel, you have the numbers. You have the azimuth and the elevation. So at the beginning of the eclipse, in the penumbral phase, the moon will have an elevation of 49.3 degrees. And on the map, you have the azimuth, that direction. At 11 past 4 in the morning, the total eclipse will begin. It's when the moon is going to get into the shade cast by the Earth. Okay, at 4:11. So just set time at the beginning of the total eclipse, which is at 11 past 4. So again, on the top panel, you have moon elevation, which in this case is 36.7 degrees. And on the map, you have the direction where the moon will be, right at the beginning of the total eclipse. The peak of the eclipse is at 4:47. So again, of time, set it at 4:47. And again, you have the elevation of the moon, which is 31.2, and the direction where the moon will be on the map, right? And the total eclipse will end at 5:23, so 23 minutes past 5. And again, just move time, change time to set it at 5:23. And you have the direction again of the moon and the elevation of the moon on the top panel, 25.3 degrees. And here in Menorca, the eclipse will occur during the night, so we won't have sun. Pay attention at the elevation of the sun, is always under the horizon. So now, for example, it's set at -26.1 degrees. And finally, the eclipse will end at 7:22 in the morning, 22 minutes past 7. When the moon is about to set here in Menorca. The moon has an elevation of 4.1 degrees and the sun has an elevation of -3.7, which is a great light for shooting the moon. In this case, we will have a supermoon, a big moon, so it's a great opportunity to shoot a really nice supermoon at this time, at 22 past 7, because the light will be in golden hour, so light conditions will be awesome. Also, you can use the augmented reality tool by tapping on the AR button to visualize the path of the moon in the sky. You have the time, the date, and the time. At the beginning of the eclipse, at 11 past 2, the moon is gonna be right there. And by dragging your finger on the screen, you can move time and see right the path of the moon during the total eclipse. At the beginning of the total eclipse, the moon is going to be right there for 11 past 4. And this is the path the moon will follow during the eclipse until it sets right in that direction. So you have everything with PhotoPills, right? You know the path of the moon in the augmented reality view and on the map. And this is everything you need to know where to frame and to look for nice compositions for the shot, right? We're now just enjoying the sunset here. So this is how we're gonna plan our eclipse here in Menorca. So just, you know, imagine, plan, and enjoy shooting a really nice picture of the eclipse. Bye-bye.